Well, today the president and CEO of Rogers and other telecom leaders today met with Canada's industry minister following the nationwide Rogers outage beginning Friday. Millions of Canadians were without cellular and internet service, and Interact systems experienced technical issues after Rogers went offline. The outage, which Rogers says was caused by a network system failure following a maintenance update to their core network. There is now at least one class action lawsuit in the works. The Minister of Innovation, Science and Industry, François-Philippe Champagne, joins me now from Montreal. Minister, thanks for taking the time. You met with Rogers.
Good to be with you, Paul.
Good. You met with Rogers CEO and President Tony Staffieri today, along with the other big telecom leaders. What was your message to them?
Well, the first thing was expressing the frustration of more than 12 million Canadians, as you said, which were impacted by the national network outage of Rogers. The frustration of hundreds of thousands of small and medium-sized businesses who, as you said, could not connect to Interact to effect payments for their customer, and the frustration of our emergency service providers as 911 was down in a number of cities in our country. So that was the first thing. The second thing I said, it was unacceptable, full stop. But once you've said that, then I said we need to work together, all of us, to ensure more resiliency. That was a failure in the system of Rogers, but what I've demanded from the telcos in Canada is three things. First, I said you need to enter into an agreement within the next 60 days to do three things. The first one is mutual assistance in case of outage. The second thing is emergency roaming. And the third thing is having a protocol around communication for the public and the authorities. And that package is very much inspired by what has been done in the United States just recently, a few days ago, is to increase resiliency in case of disaster, but we're going much further. And I was very clear with them that this is only initial steps, that I expect that we would come with more steps that we want them to take. The CRTC is going to do an investigation, is going to come with recommendation to understand what could have happened that would have caused a failure of that magnitude. And certainly we'll look at that report and look at the additional steps and best practices that we want them to implement to prevent that in the future.
Why did it take a major outage for the federal government to make those requirements?
Well, let me be clear. That's a failure of Rogers. Let's be clear, everyone who's watching tonight. That's their failure. That's their system. Now, what was existing already was an arrangement in place between the networks to help each other. Bell, TELUS, Rogers could come to their assistance. What I've demanded is that they codify that next time there'd be a very clear protocol in place to make sure that we can assist. The emergency roaming, I mean, this is something to increase the resiliency. You know, we, just like with COVID, you don't choose when you're going to have a system failure. You don't know exactly what may come, but you can choose to be better prepared. So the emergency roaming, allowing customers, in case where it's possible to move from one network to another in case of emergency, that's just smart to do. And the last thing is because I saw that their communication was wanting. Customers deserve better. And I said that to the CEO of Rogers and say, we want to have a protocol there. With communications with the customer and the authorities so that, just like we did last time, that we can put the best mind, because their system failure was so deep in the system that, you know, they had international experts from around the world looking at that to make sure that they could reestablish that. That's their failure, but my job is to make sure that they take appropriate steps to be more resilient. That's what we're doing today with the initial steps, and there'll be more to come.
So what specifically did you hear back from them about how or what they will actually do to prevent another outage like the one we just saw?
Well, first thing, unanimous agreement to the three things that I mentioned, the formal agreement within 60 days. Everyone is on board. They said, yes, Minister, we're going to do that. That's going to increase the general resiliency of our network in Canada. With respect to the network, obviously the CRTC investigation will go, we'll do a deep dive. That's what we want to see, Paul, is that there's a deep dive to understand how could this really happen? Who was responsible? What kind of backup system? What kind of protocols are in place? and learn from that so that, you know, this does not happen again. And with recommendation from the CRTC, that's going to be shared with the other telcos to make sure that everyone could look at that, making sure that this does not occur again. It's a bit like with air disasters. You go, you look, you understand what happened, and then you take additional measures to prevent that from ever happening again.
But so I get it that when you say, and I think a lot of people would agree, that, Rogers messed up here. This is on them. In to no small degree, but you're also requiring now, you know, the companies, you know, reach agreements on emergency roaming, mutual assistance during outages, and communication protocols to keep the public and authorities informed during outages. But I think what a lot of people are wondering is, why weren't these safety measures already in place?
Well, I would say, Paul, that's for them to put in place. What I'm saying is that now I'm directing them to do it.
But could, obviously could you have a lot not of that directed them to do it before? Why did it take this outage in order to have the federal government say, hey,
well,
you've got to be ready for this?
Well, this is best practice, I would say. Well, I would say this is best practice. The U.S. did that on the 6th of July. In case of natural disaster, what we're saying today is that we're saying not only they should have done it, but I'm directing them to do so that this informal assistance is complemented with that. And you know, everyone agreed. This is Rogers' failures. What we're saying now is that since you did that, now we're going to direct you to make sure that you do more and that Canadians, you know, expect more from you. And I said that in very clear terms to them. I mean they got the message, all of them. And I said, we expect more from you. So make sure you have redundancy, make sure that there's more reliability in your system, make sure you understand what your vendors, how could this have happened, and I expect you to be involved in the investigation that the CRTC will be conducting to really understand the cause of that. So what you see today is a first step of measures, but there'll be more to come, and they'll be sharing their best practices, because this did not happen on that scale to any other telcos in Canada. So this is something that we need to investigate and will be investigated.
All right, so let's talk about choice. You know, in the wake of this, Canadians coast to coast have pointed out the limited choice they have in comparison to, you know, Europe, for example, when it comes to cell phone service. Your government promised increased competition. Yet here we are with a very concentrated market in what is now an essential service. So what's the federal government going to do about that?
Well, you know, there would have been a lot to talk about with them today. Like I said, the meeting lasted more than an hour about affordability, about competition, which they know it's top of mind when I talk to them. But obviously, today was really focused on resiliency because of what millions of Canadians experience. Listen, I'm going to be fostering that at every step of the way. We issued just a new policy now to the CRTC to take into account affordability and competition, because we know those are the best tools, competition among others, to have more affordability. We'll be continuing to push them for that. I've been talking to them a number of times, and we'll use all the tools in the toolbox to make sure that we have more competition. And to give you an example, if you're referring to the Rogers-Shaw deal, I've been very clear from the get-go that I will not allow the wholesale transfer of licenses from Shaw to Rogers, that we want competition, and that my frame of mind, particularly with what we saw, there's a lot of lessons learned for them and what happened in the last few days, but I think for everyone in the industry in Canada, and clearly you can assure that I made them understand that competition and affordability are top of mind. But now we need to deal with resiliency, because that was the problem in the last few days.
Just on the Rogers-Shaw proposed merger, has your concern about that increased because of Friday's outage?
Well, certainly it's in my mind, because what we've seen was concerning to millions of Canadians. Like I said, my first message was to express the frustration, because since I could have all the CEOs at the table, I expressed the frustration in no uncertain terms to them. And they all agreed this shouldn't have not happened. This was unacceptable, and committed to enter into that formal agreement within 60 days. As initial steps, like I want to say, Paul, this is just like a down payment. The logical next step is to make a full inquiry with the CRTC will be doing, come with recommendations, because you need to understand the problem if you want to fix it. And certainly, we're going to be looking at best practices and make sure they implement that timely.
We're past time, but just quickly on the potential merger, when will your government come to a decision on that?
Well, when there's an application, there's three different entities of the government which needs to do, some independent, the CRTC needs to render a decision, the Competition Bureau, which, as you know, is very much seize of the matter, and I, as the Minister of Industry in Canada, have to look at that with respect to the license. So when there's an application in front of me, we'll be looking at that, but I think I've made my vision pretty clear that competition is top of mind as far as I'm concerned.
All right, Minister, I appreciate your time today. Thanks for speaking with us.
Thank you very much, Paul. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Vashi Capello's host of Power in Politics. See more of our show by subscribing to the CBC News channel or click the link for another video.